fun with lime. Today we will be learning about the different lines, what they are called and how to remember them. Let's read. If we hold a thread in our two hands and stretch it tight, we get a straight line. If we let it hang loose, we get a curved line. See how we get a straight line if we tie a stone to one end of the thread and let it hang. Now, in this book, we shall be learning about the straight line. So when we say line, we mean a straight line. Every time the word line is written, they mean a straight line, not a curvy line, a straight line. Let's continue reading. Neha drew vertical or standing line. Anaga drew horizontal or sleeping lines. She's drawing lines like this, so they are sleeping lines. Hamida drew inclined or sloping lines. So she is drawing lines in an incline, in a slope. Now what activity have they told us? It is very easy. Fold a paper and show vertical, horizontal and inclined lines. So you can take any sheet of marble paper or any paper that you have at home. If you fold it once, you will get like this. This is a horizontal vertical line. If you keep it down like this, it becomes a horizontal line. And if you fold it along its corners, you will get an inclined line, a triangle. When you make a triangle out of the paper, you will get an inclined line. Draw lines like the ones shown below. So how these girls have drawn, they are telling us also to draw. These are horizontal or sleeping lines. These are called vertical or standing lines. And these are sloping or inclined lines. I draw a line with the help of a book. When you draw a line, you get this is a standing line or a vertical line. I use a box to help me draw a line. You can use a box also to draw a line. This is an inclined or sloping line. I used a ruler to draw a line. You can also use a ruler and draw your lines. I drew a line just by hand without the help of any device. You can also draw lines on your own. You don't always need something to draw a line. You can draw with your free hand also. But let's learn how to remember these lines. How can we remember these lines? Now, this is your sloping or inclined line. You must always remember it is inclined line. But the most confusing one is horizontal and vertical. And what is the easiest way to remember it? You must remember sleeping, horizontal is lazy. Remember, lazy always likes to sleep. Horizontal, the lazy, always sleeping. Sleeping lines are horizontal. Why are they known as horizontal? Because they are lazy. They love to sleep. And how will you remember what is a vertical line? Remember, vertical is a standing line. And if you can't remember standing, then what should you remember? Vertical, the vertical, very tall, vertical, standing line, very tall. So using these two keywords, you will be able to remember which is a horizontal line, which is a vertical line. Again, horizontal, lazy, sleeping line. Vertical, very tall, so it is a standing line. Next, what does our textbook say? Let's see. Here you have to identify the shapes. Identify the shapes and color them. So all this you can color in your textbook. And with this we complete our fun with lines. We learned three lines today, which are sweeping or horizontal. How can we remember it? By remembering the word horizontal, lazy. Sleeping lines are horizontal lines. Inclined lines. Sloping lines are inclined lines. And vertical. How do we remember which is a vertical line? Vertical lines are very tall. Tall, standing are vertical lines. And this way you will remember your horizontal and vertical lines.
Do remember to like, share, subscribe and click the bell icon to stay updated on all of the latest videos. Please let us know in the comment section below what other lessons you would like us to make. We would love to hear from you. Thank you for watching.